How to replace the system board. Before you begin, remove the base enclosure, battery, M.2 solid-state drive, WLAN module, memory modules, fans, and heatsink. Removal. Important: take note of the routing of the display panel cable for later replacement. Remove the following cables from their connectors on the system board. Speaker cable, display panel cable, touchpad board ribbon cable, keyboard backlight ribbon cable, keyboard ribbon cable, fingerprint reader cable, hard disk drive cable, DC in connector cable, USB board ribbon cable, IR board ribbon cable. Remove the P1 Phillips head screw that secures the left hinge to the top cover. Open the left hinge. Remove the four P1 Phillips broadhead screws and the three P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Carefully lift the right edge of the system board and guide the external connectors out of the cutouts in the top cover. Remove the system board. Replacement. Lower the system board into position on the top cover. Caution: ensure that all cables are free from being pinched between the system board and the top cover. Replace the four P1 Phillips broadhead screws and the three P1 Phillips head screws that secure the system board to the top cover. Close the left hinge. Route the display panel cable along the left speaker. Replace the P1 Phillips head screw that secures the left hinge to the top cover. Reconnect the following cables to their connectors on the system board: IR board ribbon cable, USB board ribbon cable, DC in connector cable, hard disk drive cable, fingerprint reader cable, keyboard ribbon cable, keyboard backlight ribbon cable, touchpad board ribbon cable, display panel cable, speaker cable. Important: after system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings.